getting that stuff available?
I think there was trial and error to a large extent on effectiveness, but I think there were specialists in these tribes. I'm learning that from talking to these elders who really are in touch with the pre-reservation ways of doing things and some of the history that goes way back before the horse. There were specialists who were very, very good at discerning how to best prepare a medicine so that it was most effective, because they didn't have like one doctor. From what I understand, there wasn't one person in a village that was the doctor. There were people that spread out through the different ranks and social structures. Some were women with children, grandparents. There were warriors who knew certain types of medicine, and there were the storytellers who could go back and remember an epidemic in history that was many, many hundreds of generations away, and how they treated it, and how that was done as different ways of remembering how to preserve medicines. And it was very complicated compared to what we do, where you send somebody who's a kid to high school, he shows an interest in science and becomes a doctor, but they learn from specific schools that teach one form of medicine. And one doctor tries to remember a lot of stuff. Mm. Whereas some of these Indians were specialists in, and maybe they only knew five or six plants, but they really knew exactly how to manage those, collect them, and use them. And they also knew how to diagnose and look for the right symptoms, so you're treating the right illness. But drying plants, drying roots, most of the medicines are in the roots. Some are in berries. The berries were usually sun-dried. They were often pounded into a mush and then made into cakes with the hands. So a lot of these mashed berries that were turned into medicine, like hawthorn was a heart medicine. Hawthorn berries grows commonly in Lander, and wherever there's a river pretty much going through a town, we have black hawthorn, in some cases a red hawthorn called river hawthorn. And they both had different but related functions medicinally. But black hawthorn was the one used for virtually any heart problem, and for it was referred to as an old people's medicine. You get old, certain things happen. They knew in the old way of diagnosing and looking at medicines that virtually all of the problems associated with old age were treatable with hawthorn berries. Mm. And now we know that there's this magic antioxidant in hawthorn berries called OPC, the oligomeric proanthocyanid, and that strengthens capillaries. It prevents capillaries from becoming weak and leaking, which essentially is the cause of blindness in the common form. Macular degeneration has to do with a failing heart, which has to do with blood flow no longer at optimum levels, and capillary fragility is involved in all sorts of aging symptoms. And they knew that for old people, you have to have hawthorn in your diet. So it's a very special plant, even though the berries don't taste that great compared to all of the other berries, which are sweeter and more flavorful. Black hawthorn is the one berry that the Crow tribe does a sacred dance around the tree before they collect that one berry. It's usually collected by women, and it's called a moccasin dance, where they give a pair of moccasins to the tree, which is a sign of respect and something you would do for a respected elder that comes into your home, because it's so important. And this dance basically and chant is a way of thanking the Creator for this amazing plant. And it's used today. OPC is used to treat arrhythmias and strengthen a heart after a myocardial infarction where you have a weakness in the heart that needs to be built back up. It's used for those things, used for macular degeneration officially now. It was used in Germany that way for a long time before we did it in this country. In the form of bilberries and European berry. But it's very common in hawthorn. It's a hawthorn berries and flowers have that. And I have an arrhythmia myself that no longer bothers me because I always have a little bottle of tincture of hawthorn in my glove box in the truck. And giving it to lots and lots of people with arrhythmias, that some of which are debilitating, different kinds of arrhythmias. And within a half a day or so, it treats almost all of them. So that's just one example of hundreds and hundreds of these plants that people have come to know how to use through trial and error. I think most of them are ground up roots, ground into powder. In the old days with a mano and matate, where you had to grind it between two rocks. And then you can save that powder. Once it's dry, it'll be good for years and years, and you can save it. That way, a lot of foods were prepared the same way. You dry them, you powder them first, and then dry them. Some of them you cook first, boil them up for a while, and then you dry them and powder them. And they knew which ones to do that way. But then that powder could be used in food, and often different tribes had different ways of administering medicines, but since they had this understanding that food and medicine are not that far apart, often medicines were things you added to a stew pot. You didn't take a separate medicine to treat a lot of the chronic problems or metabolic problems. You just added something to the bowl that this person was eating out of. Mm-hmm. And it became part of their food.